Hey people, what's up? So guys, today's video is something very interesting about more about SQLs, more about databases. So guys, most of you might have seen MySQL, SQL servers, where you need a separate database setup and you connect that database setup with your end user or the end application or your mobile applications. So guys, in today's video, we'll see Android's embedded SQL database. That's Android SQLite. So what is something new about this? You don't need a separate database, separate setup, or any kind of administration task. It just stores data locally as a file on your mobile phones. So this is a very good concept of storing locally the files, database locally on your device. So today's video is about Android SQLite. We'll see CRUD operations with it. So let's get started, guys. On SQL Server or MySQL, where there's a different, altogether different database setup, different administration task, okay? SQL, different servers to handle all these operations. But have you ever heard of a database which is embedded on an Android device? Like, I mean, it's on the user end, on the app side, where database is stored locally as a text file on a user side. So what is SQLite? SQLite is also same performing all kinds of relational database operations like CRUD operations, but it stores the data into a text file on the device. Now, by default, Android comes with an embedded database that we'll be using today, Android SQLite. Okay, so where is it used basically? There's no servers required, no different administration setup, no different database setup. All is just that we have everything embedded on the user end, on the client side. So it is used in a lot of web browsers, lot of mobile phones is a major concept where SQLite is used. As the name suggests, Lite, it's a lighter version of the main database, relational database management systems like MySQL and SQL servers. So today we'll be seeing how a local sari shop owner displays all the sari photos, the fabric details, and all the details of sari in a user side, that is on the client side. He doesn't create a separate database on the web server and then tries to connect with its e-commerce applications and displays it. So something which is it's in the own device. So it's a very basic, very good thing. Why it is used SQLite Android, where you have a lot of frequent use of the database, frequent modification, inserts, CRUD operations, accessing the database on a quite frequent basis. It's the best thing to use SQLite Android. So today's setup will be, as I've listed the five steps, we'll create a database, something called Database Helper class, where we'll see how to create the database, how to create a table for storing the details that you see on your SQL servers. You create that tables and columns by writing SQL queries. Then obviously we'll create a model class. So we'll define all the details of saris, like its price, its name, its fabric, its photo and all. And a DAO class where we'll write methods like how to insert the database, how to read the database, how to delete the database, basically the CRUD operations code. And last but not the least, database entry, where we'll call all the methods of database DAO and we'll implement on our application. And then, you know, custom adapter concept we use in JSON parser thing. We'll read the data, we'll display it in a grid view or a list view, like e-commerce application happens in e-commerce applications. So let's get started, guys. Guys, getting started with it, our first step is to create a new class in our Android called Database Helper. So here, you know, right click, new class, Database Helper. So here are we. So what is this class about? We'll be creating the database and the tables here. So Database Helper extends SQLite Open Helper. So it's an Android inbuilt class that helps us to create the database and manage the versions of our database systems. And here I have defined all the columns that we'll be creating in the database. So all the strings, table name I've given sari data, you can create anything your wish. Column one I've given unique ID, something kind of, you know, we use in our SQLs, like in primary key, auto incrementing the IDs. And column two is sari name, the sari price is column three, column four the sari is photos, and column five a sari category where we'll define the fabric of that sari, it's a silk, it's a cotton or what is it. Then we create a constructor, database helper, and then we use the two main methods of SQLite Open Helper, that is onCreate and onUpgrade. So onCreate method helps us to implement the SQL queries and create the database and create the tables. So your string create table, we have used a command, you know, SQL query, how we write the command create table, table name, then a bracket opens, we define the five columns and the columns with its values like integer or varchar or what is it.
So create table. I have concatenated the table name. Then the bracket opens the column one, which is the unique ID. I've given it integer, primary key, auto increment. Then column two, text, that is sorry, name will be a text file, which cannot be left null. It has to be filled in mandatory. Column three, also text, not null. Column four is blob, because they're using the image, so the type is blob. And column five, again, text, which is not null. So db.execute SQL. So execsql, execute SQL is a command which is used to create the database to run the SQL queries, except the select statement queries. All the queries can be implemented by this line, db.execute SQL, okay? And then on upgrade, we'll drop the table if it already exists. If there's any table already locally made on the database storage with this same name, it will drop the table. That's it. Basically, you have created a table in this class. Then second class will be model class. We know all are familiar with the model class. We'll define all the properties of the class which we'll use. For example, string sari name, string sari price, string sari category, and bitmap sari image, and byte sari photo. This sari image URL I had used, I've just kept it here, but we are not using in this file. We'll be seeing with something different concept. For our use, we have name, price, category, image, and the sari photo, which is a type value, byte. Now you come to DAO class, where we'll be writing the code for inserting the database, inserting the values on the table, and also reading it or deleting it. For example, CRUD operations, basically. So let's go to database DAO. So again, we have made the object of database helper class, SQLite database DB. Here is the constructor, database DAO. So first method is of type boolean, which will return true or false if the queries work or not. Insert data is a method I've made where we need to insert five things: the name, the price, sorry, four things. ID is auto incrementing by its own self. The name, the price of the sari, the photo, which is of type byte, and the category, which defines the fabric. So content value is something like a map thing. It maps the value to a correct key, as like works like a key value pair. So content values are put. Sari name, sari price, sari photo, sari category. All these are coming from this class, database helper, which I've made it. Sari name, sari price, column names. So we're just mapping the column names with the, I've given the here in the method, name, price, photo, and category. And that's last but not the least, long result, db.insert in this table name sari data, content values, we'll put insert all this, all the data on the respective columns. Result return false or true depending upon if my code is correct or not. And then coming to list get data, we'll be seeing this later. After we just insert it, we'll see how to fetch the data or read the data. And basically deleting the entire database. We know the query db.delete the entire table. I've not put any where clause or argument clause. I just put emptying the entire database content, data table content. The database helper class, that is, we have created the database, we have inserted and updated the database like we have done with our CRUD operations. Now we need to implement all these methods. So first, now we'll go to database entry. So now first I'll make a layout file that user end will be visible to see what all he has to input here. So here we go to our database entry class, sorry, the Java file, the layout file. I have made some text view, some edit views, and image view, so that the user selects this all this from the photos from his gallery. He inputs the methods, sorry, the details. For example, sari name, the app owner will put the sari price, the sari fabric, and the upload image, that he'll be able to choose this image from the gallery. And then we submit the data. So you'll get to see the data has been submitted in a toast view, in a toast message, and then they'll be navigated to a new Java file where you already see a grid view of all the details that he has been inserting through his gallery. So it is as quick as it is. It's a mobile database. Just put it and you can see the data. So now database entry class. So first step, all of the details, that's okay. It's a normal thing that we see. We have defined the text view of the sari name, text view of the sari price, text view of the sari category, a button, an image view. Similarly, edit text that the user will be putting for all these three details, price, name, and the category, a button, a object of class database, and a string named called picture path. It's okay. Normal routine that we see. On create, we found the IDs of all these 9 to 10 things that we've defined on the layout files. Again, normal thing that we see in all our projects. Now, the major task, something new that we'll be seeing here is to how to select an image from the gallery. Okay. So here you can see a step by step. I've made a method called add image from gallery, a 2-line code, and intent will be performed here. Intent, new intent dot action pick. This will help us to select the image from our install apps. And the install app, I mean, I'm using your gallery, media store dot images dot media dot external content view, right? And as you see, start activity for intent, you're using start activity for result intent. And we are passing a code called result load image, which I've defined the user defined value 1. Now, if this is successfully done, that is the gallery opens, user can select the image, it will pass the result load image 1. If it is 1, then the performance can be done smoothly, otherwise, there will be some error. I've defined a byte array of type of name image, which I've kept it null. Now, an override method called onActivityResult. Now, three things have been passed here. The request code, that is nothing but this one, the result code, which is a user defined code result, okay, and the data that is coming from the intent. Now, if the request code is result load image, that is 1, result code is result okay, that is the user can help successfully select the image from the gallery, and data is not null. Data, what is which data? Intent data that is coming from here. So, the data that we saw, the image that we saw, it is not null. There's some photo on our gallery, then URI selected image is equal to data.getData. So I've defined a URI which is used to identify the resource, that is the type of thing that I've chosen from the gallery. It's a video, it's an audio, it's an image, what is it? That data.getData. Now the data is with us, the image data is with us, JPG or PNG, anything that is with us. We'll try to put this into a new column in our database as it happens, table columns. So I've defined a string array, file path column. So data is coming from media store dot images dot media dot data. That is nothing but this image from the gallery. We got it and put it inside the new column, which I've named file path column. Now what is cursor doing here? Cursor helps us to perform on the result activity, result set of the queries. Query as in the query of getting the image from the gallery. Now perform the result set operation. So dot query. Selected image, what is it? The URI, that is image from the file path column, that is here. So cursor that moved dot first. Nothing, we did nothing here. Just with the help of cursor, we performed some result set operations on our existing query. We got the image from our gallery. We inserted that the file path inside the column, named file path column inside the table database. Now column index is finding on which column index has the data has the image been inserted inside the database. Get column index from this array file path column and get string. Now we got the column index, we need the path of the picture to fetch the image from the database. As you know, we stored the path of the image, you don't store the store the entire image to save the database size. It's in the bitmap form, so we convert the image BMP, get bitmap from the URI. We've passed the path of that image and we have stored in a bitmap file. Now, we know we have stored the database. In the database, the image is stored in the form of byte form. So, converting the byte via bitmap to a byte, byte array output stream, new byte array output stream, bitmap but compress image byte to stream to byte to array. So, from bitmap, we have converted into byte. Now, this byte we can help to insert. Now, we'll be performing our code of add data to database. So, result database DAO dot insert data. This was a method in the inside a DAO class. So sari name dot get text, sari price dot get text. All these are edit text that the user has been putting it here. For photo, we have put image. Image was nothing but not this image. Image was coming from the byte form of the bitmap and sari category. So now we have put all the details inside the database. If the result will be true, then sari details will be added successfully. Otherwise, the error will come. Normal thing. Delete data, same database DAO, but delete the method, sign up, delete successfully, or some problem has occurred. So now we have inserted our data inside the database. We'll read it. Again, we'll go back to DAO class, which we had. We didn't cover one method under the DAO class of reading the data. So inside the DAO class, we'll go to read data method. So get data, get writable database. So this method helps us to open the database. It's like a cache form. Now we can read all the details of the database coming. So we've created a list of name, sorry, details list, new array list, a string, array of string called table columns, sorry, unique ID, sorry name, all the column names you have been passed here. So database.query, sorry data. So table name is sorry data. The table columns, here you have the array of columns of these five columns. No any kind of specific selection like where clause, order by, group by. It's like a select star or something, all the data. Cursor.move to first. So if we have not reached the last, cursor is after last, we'll put all this inside the array list, that is sari details list. We have created an object of sari details, the model class, and just put all the details inside the index wise. That's it, as simple as that. Now we'll create a custom adapter. We know we have seen that in JSON parser. So a custom view, how the user sees the data. So a database custom view or layout file where you have one image, the sari price, the sari name, and the sari fabric. Okay, just normal drag and drop. So custom adapter, we'll see it here, database adapter class. Normal, you know, extends the array adapter of type sari details as a model class. We have made a constructor, get view. We all know this concept of layout in Python. We have seen in JSON parser class. So image view, ID, text view, all the IDs you have found from of this class of response view.xml layout file, names dot set text from the it's coming from the model class dot get position dot get sari name, get position get sari price, get position dot get sari category. Again, we have to display the image in the bitmap form because our database had in byte form. An inverse operation we saw from bitmap to byte in our activity class. Now from byte to bitmap to show in the custom list view. So byte images you're getting from the sari details. So bitmap, decode the byte by array, decoded image dot length and image use of depth, set bitmap. As simple as that. So what did we cover in today's tutorial? We saw an SQLite kind of database where there's no different server, no different database setup, an embedded database, something very new, something very raw. Now we'll see the output of this application. We'll do the run app and we'll see how the database is.